The Indian military is one of the best in the world, ranked at number 4 on the scale of total military power. Within the Indian military, the Marine Commandos are very elite and are among the best of the best in the entire world. Marine Commando stands for MARCOS, and it's the Special Forces Unit of the Indian Navy created for conducting special operations in maritime environments. They are called the Few, the Fearless, as they are one of the most feared Indian forces. How's it going, everybody? My name is Leroy Kenton, and welcome to another episode of FTD Facts. Now, I know quite a bit of you guys have been requesting for us to do a video about MARCOS for quite a while. I'm super excited to do this video because, like, these guys are just so intense. But before you continue watching, don't forget to just, you know, give this video a thumbs up if you're liking these episodes. And if you're new here to FTD Facts, you gotta hit that subscribe button as well as that bell notification, because I'm telling you, like, you don't want to miss any videos. Okay, so let the fun begin. So, the Marine Commando Force, or the MCF, was created as a special forces unit by the Indian Navy in 1987. For many years, the Indian Navy wanted to establish an elite force for special maritime operations. A year earlier, in April of 1986, the Indian Naval Staff created a plan for a special force which would be able to conduct recon raids and even counter terrorist operations in a maritime environment. 3 naval officers were sent for training with the US Navy SEALs, and further training was conducted with the British Special Forces. These 3 naval officers formed the first nucleus of the Indian Maritime Special Forces, which was then formally raised in February of 1987. Then shortly after, in 1991, they had its name changed to the Marine Commandos Force, the MCF, and are now familiarly known as MARCOS, simply the Marine Commandos. Now, the men selected to be Marine Commandos are amongst the fittest officers as well as sailors of the Indian Navy. They're selected when they are young, in their early 20s, and have to go through a very intense selection process as well as training process. The Marine Commandos are trained for operations on air, land, and sea. So you can see, like, the prefix Marine is, like, mainly just for formality, since they are from the Navy. But in general, you can call them, like, the all-in-one commandos, because they specialize in things like parajumping all the way to deep sea diving. Now, the people training to be a part of MARCOS have to complete a 2-year course, the first phase of which lasts just 1 month, in which they undergo many rigorous physical tests, of which only 50% of them pass. A 20-kilometer run starts the beginning of every day in MARCOS training. Now, the next day, it's a 20-kilometer night trek with 60-kilogram loads. This routine is on alternate days, and there's no, like, digital simulations or dummies or anything like that used in MARCOS training. The training is conducted with live ammunition, and guns are always loaded. It leaves no chance of any sort of friendly fire, so you can't be playing around during training. No, someone could actually die. Then, for the next 9 months, they're taught how to use different types of weapons, as well as conduct special warfare techniques, and how to gather intelligence from their enemy. Now, this part of the training is conducted in conjunction with other Indian Special Forces at the Combined Commando School at Surasawa. They also have to go through a parachute training course and a diving course. Now, the Indian Marine Special Force first went into action a few months after its rising in Sri Lanka to fight against the liberation of Tamil Tigers, ELAM, the LTTE. In November of 1988, mercenaries of the People's Liberation Organization of Tamil ELAM, which was a party used to oppose the LTTE, well, they attempted a coup in the Maldives, and the Indian Armed Forces quickly began an operation to re-establish the former government. Under the code name Operation Cactus, Indian paratroopers on November 4th, 1988, swarmed the capital. However, 46 mercenaries with 27 hostages, including the Maldivian Minister of Education, they all managed to escape on board a merchant ship, until 2 Indian Navy vessels were able to capture it. So let's fast forward from that fact to MARCOS today. Now, the strength of the unit is a very closely guarded secret. However, sources say that the number could be close to 2,000 operatives and 10 groups of 200 personnel each. However, sources say that the number could be close to 2,000 personnel in 10 groups of 200 personnel each. Although Marco's members are qualified to use a parachute and even undergo a combat diver's course, which is not really a common practice in other commando forces, only a few manage to complete the free-for-all parachute training, and it's these few that are selected for operations with Cosmos CE-2F-X-100 two-man submarines. Now, the unit's quick rise has changed the unit's role. It was intended to be dedicated to special maritime operations, but a considerable part of Marco's is doubling as a Marine infantry assigned to the 340th Brigade with the usual flexibility of commando forces. Marco's has also been very active in Kashmir as part of the counter-terrorist efforts. Their main task is to control the infiltration of enemies from Pakistan to Kashmir through the Jhelum River and Wular, a 65 square kilometer fresh lake. Now, did you know that Marco's are widely feared among terrorists who call them Didawala Fauj, meaning the bearded army, because of their bearded disguises that they wear in civilian areas? And these Marine commandos can be launched into operations from ships, aircrafts, and submarines, as I mentioned earlier, in full combat gear. Their transport vehicles consist of HAL Druv, Westland Sea King, the HAL Chitak helicopter, all-terrain vehicles, ATVs for short, and the Indian Navy Swimmer delivery vehicle. And finally, just recently on October 6th of 2017, Marco's on board an INS Trishul carried out an anti-piracy operation in the Gulf of Aden. They stopped a piracy attempt on the Indian ship, the MV Jag Amar. One AK-47 and one magazine with 27 rounds were recovered. 12 suspected pirates were also captured. So yeah, you see, these guys are no joke. In a world where danger lurks around every corner, the Marine Commandos definitely help make things a little safer for the people of India as well as other parts of the world. This episode of FTD Facts is brought to you by Grammarly.com. Grammarly is the world-leading software in improving your written English skills. There's hundreds of spelling and grammatical errors all built into Grammarly's softwares that can automatically correct you when you make mistakes, some mistakes that you're making every single day and you probably don't even realize it. The link is down below where you can install Grammarly for free and make the smart decision like many of the FTD Facts viewers out there have. And guys, be sure to follow me on Instagram. The link is down below as well. And leave your suggestions and comments about what other future FTD Facts episodes you want to see next. And for everybody that made it this far in the video, if you want to see more military videos or videos just in general about the different parts of the world, check out this playlist of recommended videos that we have for you. So yeah, enjoy those, stay educated, and I'll see you real soon in another video.